Hello, welcome to Winfield again. Of course, I made this little video the other day. I wanted to show everyone, you know, what it really is like here. You know, car lots, hotels, car lots, hotels. But what's more interesting about this is that it's a four-lane downtown strip, but it's really supposed to have centered parking. Original design for these home, you know, small towns is like that. And so, like I said yesterday, there's a whole bunch of small businesses here. Most of them are tucked in really tight, like this one over here. There's one in the back, and there's one in this long one, and there's a plant flower and such. And then there's puppies. Little girls running across the street. But, for the most part, it's pretty common. Petrol, gasoline station. Monuments, store, which is actually for, like, you know, graveyards and other things, like, if you want to have, welcome to the Smith's house, and there's, like, liquor store. It used to be my chiropractor's office. There's some Asian restaurant, or Asian food store. My favorite video store. Another bank. Hardware store, of course. And there's a lot of rent-to-owns. Like Hometown and Atlanta Center and a whole bunch of little performing arts things, like this marquee place and furniture. And bookstores and Sears. Even Sears is actually still in a small town thing. I'm gonna go ahead and drive a little further than I should to go ahead and show you. It's a big bank. And lots of little stores. In fact, a little miniature mall inside that building. And then there's, we got our Radio Shack, which barely is a Radio Shack. And, funny enough, we actually have a skating rink in this town. Winfield Cleaners. This is gonna make you laugh. Because, there's our skating rink right there. But there's guns right there. And here's our train station. Our old train rail. Which they have some train rides on. I'm going to take you to the city park, which is called Island Park, and you're going to see why in just a second. Slow down. The city's pool's right here, too. I've never been to this one, though. Then again, I've never been to many city pools after the transition, so welcome to Island Park. And it's an island. It really is. And I go across the bridge. And little structure monument thingy. And the big thing about Island Park is that there's geese. And geeselets. Isn't that cute? Oh! Stop for traffic! They're quackers over me. Anyways, it's actually fuller than it usually is. I guess all this rain's been a good thing. They, sadly, the child content, or miscontent, keeps setting this, children's toy place on fire. It's a castle meant for children to play on, and the community actually bought it last time. Actually had to donate into it, and they're doing it again. This time I think they're gonna go for some security. I think it's pretty ridiculous that it got set on fire again, but I think that they need to start looking for people bragging about it, because it's not like it's an accident.
Yeah, it
it's pretty interesting how there's an island here. I'm wondering, I always wonder if they made it. You know? Because it doesn't seem likely that water would flow around in a circle and only have one inlet, which is that. Actually, that's pumped. That's the river. Walnut River provides water to this. And anyways, there's a lot of boring rest of the thing, including a pier. And actually, my girlfriend and I, we actually made out over here, which is really hilarious because it got pretty impressive. And I'd have to say, I'd rather see someone being that way than burning down the park. So I actually had an art show here a few years back, and it was really nice. So here's the inn, there's the bridge. And I'm going to go ahead and show you me going out of town real quick. Not going out of town on this end of the town, so you're going to see a little more, including the skating rink again, which I think I missed when I drove by first time. You didn't probably see it. This is the only scary thing about this exit, is that there's not really a light, and this is a Highway 77, so it's a big to-do not to run into people, and it's only 30 miles per hour, so, yeah. We would have a lot more businesses here in town if business owners actually gave a crud. See, there's the skate rink. Nice little skate rink. I've heard plenty of nice things about it. And this is like some kind of bar. This is Liquorama. Chinese restaurant. And some guy is showing off his stuff, which has nothing to do with anything. But we have our braggarts, so that's how it works. Small little businesses. And our Radio Shack again. And Biederman's, which is an okay restaurant. It's good if you're hungry. And it's a museum somewhere. I've never seen the museum. No, I don't go. Yeah, I was in the midst of a turn, and here I come. This is me going out of town to the west. And there's something particularly interesting about this town, which is that it's the county thing. It's a cute little shop called the Cupcake Shop, and it's actually for little kids and their children and stuff to make them all look cute. Which I think is really important to make them all look cute. I just don't think that they should be over-sexualized, though. I think that the classic German-Hungarian strudel stuff is, like, the most awesome thing for children. And then that way, you know, they can look back and they know that they were Hansel or Gretel. Everything's horrible. Anyway, there's some grain silos which used to have use of the tracks, and then the tracks so that people can die, you know, when it runs out of rail. And this is the big thing. They have the Walnut Valley Festival here, including the county fair, which they do 4th of July fireworks at too. So that's about it. They have RVs parked on both sides, like millions of them, so. And welcome to the Walnut River. Thank you for watching my video about Winfield, Kansas.